Let's see that song. Show some love for the burrito lady. Tamale lady and the hot dog lady, and they're all territorial. They act worse than the hookers on Sunset Boulevard. I was like, gee, ladies, we're only trying to sell our food, not our papoosie. But I'm keeping the name the burrito lady, because I friended and I gave a lot of burritos out on credit. And I just want to let everybody know that the burrito lady's alive and well, and bitch better have my money. Yeah, so a little bit about myself. I was born and raised on a taco truck. By the time I was 8 years old, I had 3 jobs. My dad was a asshole. My mom didn't want her daughters working, so he had her ass deported. And it was crazy growing up with him. He thought he was in the Mexican mafia. He guarded our chichis like they were smuggling in his kilos of coke. He didn't let us do nothing. Every day he'd pick us up at the high school in that big old taco truck. I was so embarrassed. I wanted off that taco truck. I started to rebel. So on my 15th birthday, my dad gave me a cooler full of burritos. I was all pissed off. I know when a Mexican girl turns 15, she gets a quinceañera or a car. Shit, all I got was a cooler with wheels on it and kicked out of the house. And some advice from my dad. He's all, yeah. He goes, now you're the burrito lady. He said, you're going to have to be careful. Because there's going to be a lot of guys out there that are going to want to give you their burritos. You know, the chorizo sausage. Even the little hot links are going to try to get that. He goes, just keep your legs closed as tight as a Mexican border. I was like, okay, Dad, I'll try. So a few years passed, and I tried to keep my legs closed as tight as a Mexican border. But you know the Mexicans, they always find a way in somehow. Kids. And shit, now I'm stuck homeschooling these kids. And when one of them starts out wanting help with their homework, I start sweating and getting all nervous. Cause thanks to the public school system, I didn't learn shit. Shit, I barely found out we were thrown in a bubble somewhere in the universe. And my son's all, yeah, Mom. He goes, it says right here in this book, it says that we're mammals. I go, mammals? That sounds like an effing whale. I don't think we're mammals. So anyway, I call my sister. She's all smart. She reads millions of books. And I'm all, hey, Isaiah's over here trying to say we're mammals. She's all, yeah. He's absolutely right. If you give birth to the canal and breastfeed, she said, we are mammals. Shit, I put up that phone, I told my son. I go, shit. I go, we ain't mammals. I go, we ain't mammals. Mammals are lazy. We mammals are Mexicans. We work hard every day. Let's see. So, talking about Viagra. I just recently broke up with my husband. The last time I was with him, he got me so loaded. He had me on tequila, Corona, and like 5 bong hits of that miracle marijuana. And shit, it was on. He had me all over that bed and everything. And I was all, hey. Oh, I looked up and I started getting sober and I seen the clock. I was all, hey, you've had an erection for more than 4 hours. Do you want me to take you to the hospital? He's all, nah. He goes, just turn over. So anyway, I'm over here like this, another couple hours. I'm all, hey, hurry. You're going to have to take me to the hospital. You're going to crack me in half. So anyway, after that, I decided I was going to close up shop. My back was hurting me, my hip, I believe my lungs were killing me. So now all I'm looking for in a guy is an erectile. Oh wait, oh shit. All I'm looking for in a guy is friendly conversation, take me to dinner, and an erectile dysfunction. Yeah, leave me alone. So anyway, sorry for all you people with the new technology, the camera phones and the computers and all that. Shit, people could take a picture of this. Somebody could sneak and record you guys having sex. And it goes on the internet, it goes viral. And everybody's zooming in and zooming out and checking out your stuff. It's so embarrassing. I just want to say, I thank God that technology wasn't around when I was a young girl. The only thing I have to worry about is a couple of Polaroids. Walking around with my boots on them. And I'm offering a reward. If anybody finds them, I'm offering a reward because I would love to see my 18-year-old titties again. Thank you, everybody. That's my story.